building up his fan base step by step.
Yeah, and you know, to think about the last two games we've seen, Apollo, in the first one we saw that ridiculous, like, 80 gate come out by Inori. It was actually only 9, but it was quite a few. Had him spread out really nicely. And then, of course, Stefano with his late game crazy Zerg Air Army. Let's introduce our players here in the Northeast. We have got our red Protoss. He is Inori. Give it up. And here in the southwest position on Daybreak, our pink Zerg from Millennium, the Foreigner's last hope. Give it up for Stefano.
And it is a dilemma game. It's like, Foreigners never do well in events, or Protoss never do well in events. So, not sure which one it's going to be today.
I know, how do you root? How do you root?
Well, I don't know. I'm a biased commentator. I'm rooting a little bit for Stefano here. Just going to put that out there. But at the same time, I would like to see Inori advance through, but my heart, I think, belongs with the Swarm here with Stefano.
All right. I like that.
You like that? I think you're on the same wavelength as well.
I'm on the same wavelength, but at the same time, again, I love to see emerging talent. Inori has shown some amazing games, and to me, that's a player who basically says, without saying it, you know, actions or words through actions, is that I deserve to be in the spot that I'm in. And, you know, both of these guys deserve it. In fact, it's almost saddening that they have to face each other and knock one or the other out into the semifinals, because I think that both these players have shown through this particular tournament that they kind of deserve to be in the semifinals.
And we are going to see a Nexus first. Once again, the probe was sent out nice and early after that pile on Seas. There was no early spawning pool. There's no aggression coming from Stefano. So we are going to go ahead and get this Nexus down first. On the other hand, though, the gas has been taken as well a little bit earlier than normal, rather than trying to get down that hatchery ASAP. And Stefano is a player that is extremely hard to predict. He can do anything. And I really love the way that Stefano also, he has the unit mechanic and drill mechanic down to the very wire. He will build in different stages. A lot of the times, you know, Protoss players, Terran players will move out to force a Zerg player to make units rather than drones. And Stefano capitalizes on that a lot, and even punishes these small move outs because he already has units ready and waiting.
And the probe did stick its head back into the base to see what exactly is going on in there. While that happened, Stefano managed to sneak out that hatchery, so he did get his base down. Forges up, and the first gateway has gone up as well. Second pylon there, guarding that Nexus. And I mean, right now, Inori pretty much going similar to what he did last time, just kind of changing his wall composition here a little bit as the photon cannon goes down. He will also hold on to the Zelnaga Tower. We talked about this in another matchup. It happened to be, I don't remember. I believe it was a TVT, but the vision in this tower is going to be incredibly important.
Oh, most definitely. And so far, with the gateway, if you notice, we talked about before, the gateway is at a different timing this time. It was a lot faster, which means the cyber core is going to be a lot faster, which is not going down yet, which is a little bit surprising here. So he's losing a lot of time here. And on the other hand, though, probe is going around, scouting for no 4-minute 30 base. And now we do have speed on the way, gas taken out as well. So Stefano playing very, very mineral heavy. And still, no cyber core. It's incredibly low.
There it is. Going down at the front right there. Creating a full wall here for Inori, and it was pretty late. And although it has not been scouted yet, there's that third base from Stefano. And I've got a feel that after the results from the last game, that Stefano is like, this is something I can handle. I'm confident in doing, especially based off of how the Protoss began this matchup and how he saw it unfold in the previous game. So there is a Zealot out. He'll take his own tower. But that also means that there is no block here, so he does have a limited amount of time. Typically, the second Zealot will come out and just take that block, but I'm not sure that he's going to be able to get over, sort of even scout this third with the Zealot. I think he's only going to be able to do it with the probe. The Zerglings are out now. They have speed, and look at that, just kind of heading out, and that game sense tells him that something would be out and around there, but the probe's going to go all the way around to the northwest. And there it looks like that, look at that micro there on the Lings. As you see, all of those Lings retained. Very, very nicely done by Stefano.
Yeah, and Stefano basically picking up on player patterns is what you can do as you get, oh, actually that probe is hiding up there for something, but it's going to have to retreat now. But yeah, player patterns, I mean, you can see that Inori goes for this Zealot right away to go take Zalnalatau, maybe poke around a little bit, and Stefano just picks up on that nice and easy, does kill it, and now is searching for that probe. Probe is going to be found and taken down nice and early, so that's pretty good. For Stefano, if we just compare that probe to the game we saw on Taladrin Malta, if a pile had gone down, which I think that was planning on happening, and as you can see, the gateway count is now increasing, and we are going to have another execution-based play, and that's an incredible amount of gateways. The thing is, though, Stefano already smells something's up just by finding that probe up there.
Yeah, I think he did, based off of that, and certainly adapting to his opponent's play because of that. Now, Lair's on the way, the Roachhorn's being constructed. He's still droning at this point, and he's got his Evo Chamber coming out. Now, the one thing that's kind of concerning from Stefano's point of view is the only vision into his opponent's face that he's going to have is this one Overlord over here. And if you just check out current vision, you can see that he's only spotted what's going on in the natural.
And Stefano is making sure there is no pylon. He's moving these lings around everywhere because he does not want to lose the same way now. And now we've gone over the 8-minute mark. He knows that Warp Gate it should be done and is done and is now building nothing but units now. And he will build nothing but units. He has a ling that sees these units and probe incoming, the most important thing here. So he knows this attack is coming. The creep spread is connected from the second to the third this time as well, DJ Wheat, which is a lot different from Taladrin Malta. And Stefano, once again, going to pick up vision of these units, sees the pylon with the range as well. He knows exactly what's coming, but can he handle it?
Yeah, now is he going to go off? If he could snipe this probe here before it goes down, and that's not going to happen, but he will see the pylon with the lings if he gets the probe. And can he get the pylon? If he gets this, it will thwart this attack, but it looks like it goes up. He doesn't want to sacrifice those units. And so he will allow the pylon to be built. A lot of zealots coming in. He thinks now he'll know exactly where these units are going to come from. And there it is. It won't be a surprise this time. Oh. Force fields need to be really effective here. And the lings go past. Get a surround there. And do manage to take out at least the sentry. But force field's not as effective.
If he hits every lava inject, DJ Wheat, Stefano should be fine here. I mean, he's got enough, but his units, his lings have to hit the stalkers as well. Stefano is pushing this back really nicely. And his link control is superb. Keeping them alive, not letting zealots beat them down.
And there are no more force fields coming out this unless there are some new sentries on the field. There might be one out of this guy here in just a moment, but not having those force fields with this type of an army is going to be rougher. He's going to have to wait a couple of moments here before it happens. Some spine crawlers going down as well. And as these zealots begin to fall, the sentries going too. And the roach count is getting higher and higher. This is not like that first map that we saw where Stefano was essentially throwing some units away. But keep in mind that gateway count is high, and so we're seeing a lot of units come in. There it goes. All the sentries are gone. The roaches are pushing forward.
And it looks like Stefano's going to do it. The zealot wall has gone down now, so the stalkers are very, very vulnerable to these lings and to these roaches. Plus one is finished on these roaches as well. Stefano's going to chase this down. Stefano wants to go to the next round.
He really, really does here and doing a great job. He decides to pull back just a little bit, and as you see the retreat from Inori, or not. Don't jump the gun, guys. It looked like he was going to turn around and go back. And
yeah.
there was sort of a rotation of this army, but he's not going to sway his attention at all here. Just could possibly be a shift around. Maybe he'll decide to attack from another angle.
Well, he is going to pull out very, very shortly. He's building gas. Stefano's building drones now. He knows it's over. He has successfully defended against this gateway execution-based play here from Inori. Meanwhile, double gases have been taken from Inori. Hasn't even gone into them yet, and he will want to throw down a robo or try to take a third base. But as you can see, creep has been spread by Stefano on that third base, and Stefano is just playing so well. He's going to clean up these two pylons as well. Stefano is going to just go for the direct counterattack, DJ Weed, throwing down another macro hatch, rebuilding nothing but roaches, and Inori is on the back foot.
Yeah, there's only one sentry out too with a single force field. So because of Daybreak and the way that it's actually, you know, configured here, there's a lot of attack routes potentially for Stefano as he's going to make his way over to this third, see if it is up, and notices that the Overlord's been cleared out, will spot this one pylon. That, of course, will give away the army positioning. That probe goes down, and that one had every intention of expanding here. And how does he fight into this? There's a very, very narrow choke. Probably isn't going to want to be there.
And this pylon actually kept alive here, which could be a little bit dangerous for Stefano. I think he knows because he's got the creep there, so he's just going to go pick it off. And yeah, he's going to send a single Zergling to take that out. But once again, we're seeing Stefano denying that third base, not letting a Protoss get the gas, not letting him take it down. The probe and pylon will get sniped off instantly once again. Oh no, the Nexus, is it going to get picked off? It gets picked off here. Not cancelled. The pylon was cancelled, but Stefano. Wow.
Yeah, and I mean, he's spreading the Protoss army out. He's preventing him from grabbing a third. We've got Lings that are potentially set up for a counterattack here as well. And he's going to move his army down. Not sure I like that idea. He's going to catch him as he goes up the ramp. Again, there's only a couple of force fields here to throw out, and I would love to see some sort of flanking maneuver. And look at that. He's going to split up his army right now. The rest of it's going to go around from the other side, and that's exactly what Stefano is going to do. He's going to just completely surround all these units, and here we go. The Lings go in. The Roaches come up from the back. The Ford Hope could possibly keep it alive here versus Inori. As we see his units begin to fall, Blink is not yet done. There's nowhere for these Stalkers to go. The probes are going to come out. And Apollo, I think Stefano has done it.
Yeah, he has, DJ Wheat. GG. Stefano, the remaining foreigner, comes back from being one game behind. He stays composed. He goes the distance and takes two maps away from Inori to advance into the next round, where he will be going up against the STC, who is a Terran player, and Stefano is known for his Zerg versus Terran, and the non-Koreans have a lot of hope here.
Stefano played remarkably that game, but let's give it up for